So whenever we are downloading any application, then that application available in executable form, particularly on Windows. As you can see, recently I downloaded one just you can see one Ludo. So in this Ludo, you can see this is a Ludo game, and when I am clicking on this, then Ludo will not be running. Then just first Ludo will be installed. It will ask to us that it is being installed, and then I will say yes, and I will do on next button, click on next button, and now I am installing this. Then you can see that it has been installed on my PC, and then either the icon will be available on my desktop or it will be just writing. So Ludo is available there. I am clicking on Ludo, then you will be seeing Ludo is open. So when we are doing programming, then nobody is teaching us that how to create installable package. Such type of things were available in Visual Studio and Visual Studio.NET directly, but particularly in Java and NetBean, it is supported by third party directly. I think as per my knowledge, it is not available. So when we are writing Java program, then it is really difficult then how to create installable package so that we can be guided to install the complete software. So today we will be learning that. For that purpose, I am telling you two sites. Two sites are there, Inno and WiX Setup are available for this purpose. They are two different, or you can say the third party softwares, and you can install both on the on your PC. And just once more I am telling what are the names of that: Inno Setup and WiX Setup. The full form of WiX Setup, you can see that is Window Installer XML. Then you can see here Window Installer XML. That is why we are saying it is WiX Toolset. Now, but now question is this: how to set up it? So first of all, you have to install Window Installer and Inno Setup from these two sites. After going into downloads, and you can download both. After just installation of these two, you can come back to the program files, and you can see here they will be available in program files, and just I am clicking on Inno, Inno. So you can see here that this Inno folder is available there. You have to memorize the path of this one, because it is to be set up as environment variable in path variable. And same thing, you can go back and you can see, friends, that there will be one more, that will be WiX, W-I-X, W-I, W-I-X, I think. So WiX toolset, WiX toolset is there, WiX toolset is there. So this path is also to be copied. Okay, after that you have to go to this my PC, and properties. In properties, you are coming to the advanced settings. In advanced settings, environment variable. In environment variable, system variable, you have to find out, and just check for path variable. So path variable is available there. Windows 10 is providing this facility in a very excellent fashion and very intuitive fashion, that at this place you can add the new path, a new variable can be added here. So if you are not just interested, then just I removed one. So can I do undo? Control Z. I am trying, but Control Z is not working here. So, but I don't know which path has been deleted right now. I will check it later. So, but I am not doing okay. Okay, I am going back, and then I am seeing that okay, that was the path of PuTTY. So I got it back. Now two paths are there, Inno and WiX. Both paths are to be put there. One up to bin, and another one Inno. At this place you have to add. In which way you are adding, just click on new and add the paths. Okay, so just go back, and now come to the NetBean, and in NetBean right now I am going to create a new project, and that project is having just you can say Java application. I am clicking on that, and I am creating a simple Java application, Java application 21. So in Java application 21, now you are looking Java application 21, it is there. And now I am going to create one new and then JFrame form I'm going to create. In JFrame form, new frame I'm creating. Now you are looking here something. I will be creating a very small application, just one button and one text box. Okay, so where is text box? Just you have to find out button label this text field. Okay, so text field is there. I am putting this text field here. Name of this I am not selecting here. So just on this one you can, okay, no double click, just right click and edit. Right click and add.
हेलो दोस्तों, हमारी वीडियो को लाइक एवं सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें. आपको हमारी वीडियो को लाइक करने के लिए इस आइकन पर क्लिक करना होगा तथा सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए आपको इस बॉक्स पर क्लिक करना पड़ेगा. आप हमारी वीडियो को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए इस बेल आइकन पर भी क्लिक कर सकते हैं. इन दोनों का एडवांटेज आपको ये रहेगा कि जब भी हमारी कोई नई एक इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो आएगी तो आपके YouTube अकाउंट के टॉप पर बेल आइकन पर एक अलर्ट आ जाएगा.
एडिट टेक्स्ट, सो आई एम सेइंग TEST टेस्ट एंड आई एम नॉट गिविंग नेम ऑफ दैट. So what I have to do on this one, I am just event action performed I am doing, and what is the name of my text box, you can see it here. I am J text field 1, so J T E X T F I E L D 1 dot S E T set T E X T set text. Okay, now just close it in double click and then I am writing just TEST. Okay, because everything for testing. So first I have to come back here and try to run it. Okay, and then I am seeing what is the performance of my application. Now just double click on that. Okay, so test is there. So I created my small application and that is GUI. Now by default for this application 21, this page will be called whenever I am running it. So you can see that if I am running it, then by default Java application 21 will be called. That is why I am not getting anything new frame etc. Nothing is there. So what I have to do, I have to call this new frame inside this one. So what I am doing, just new new frame new frame dot, just check it out, is it working or not. Okay, no problem. So new frame n equal to new frame. Okay, so I created new frame, it is giving some error, new frame. So I have to find new J frame. Basically it is new J frame. So I have to write here new J frame. J and same thing is here, new J frame. So I think now there should not be any error. New J frame. New J F R A M E F R A M E new J frame. Why this error is there? So I have to find out what is the error there and what is the exact name of that class. Everything new J frame extend it is okay. So just copy it here. Okay, refactor new J frame. Now I will be seeing that what error is there. Same error, no error. Okay, so error, now you can understand what was the reason of error. Now if you are just declaring, then nothing will happen. You have to n dot main main and null null. I am calling it. Now you will see I created the object of this frame class and then I am calling the main function of this frame class. So whenever you are just running on it, then you can see this frame will be called automatically. So my application is working fine. So up to this it is okay, but now question is this: how to make installable package of it? When you are right click after the installation, as I told you, either you have to install Inno or you have to install this WiX. After installation, you have to set the path inside the environment variable, and now come back to the NetBean. And when you are going to generate a package of that, then no any option is available. But you have to do a small change there. You have to enable packaging. So you have to go at this place and compiling and this deployment. So in this deployment, you have to you have to just select this option, enable native packaging, and then click on OK button. After that, it will take some time and some type of setup will be made. And now after that, you will see package as option there. Okay. So in packages option, you can go for MSI installer, and it will be taking some time in the creation of package, but finally you will be getting the installable package inside a place that I will tell you just after the completion of that. It will be taking some time, so it is okay, just you have to wait. So I can go back and I can try that where is that package. I am going to this document, inside documents, my NetBean projects, my Java application 21, then dist. Now at this place nothing is available. Okay, I am checking that why it is not available. So nothing is available in form of package. Okay, once more I will be trying. Okay, so now come back and package as. So I think now EX installer, I am trying for the EX installer, and I will be going back to my application. Now at that place I have to find out any executable, no GNPL build class Java application. Okay, I will be checking why it is not available there. I will test it. Why native package mode launching FX deploy. Okay, no problem. Once more we can try, and just I am coming to the place packaging. Okay, no problem. Package as EX installer. Okay, so in this bundle now you are looking Java application 21 and 1.0 executable file is available. So this is my package. Now you can supply this package to your end user, and now you can copy paste it anywhere. Now I am pasting it on my desktop, and now it will be taking some time. Now this is my complete setup. Now I can install it and then I can enjoy it. Now you are looking the first window of install and package appear there. Now you have to click. Now you are looking what type of things are to be copied and installed on your system. So I prepared the installation package successfully, and now it will take very less time in the installation, and finally it has been installed. Now directly it is running, and now I can click on it and you will see my installable package is ready. If you want to search out it from this place, then just you have to give the name java. Now you are looking java, my Java application is there, and you can start it from this program file also. java, java application 21. Basically earlier I started Java application, so you can remove this one and test. So my installable package is working fine. Okay, thank you friends. If you have any question, then just you can ask that question in comment, and please be on my channel. I will be coming back with a new video. Okay, thank you friends.